number one most critical key thing that you must do. The holidays are the time when you want to focus on the top 20% of products that you want to sell and market for the holidays. The big mistake people make during the holidays is they try to market their entire store. They try to market every product in the store. They have no inventory focus, so they have done all this work to have all this great inventory, wonderful holiday inventory, but instead of marketing just that inventory that they source specifically for the holidays, people are kind of on autopilot trying to market everything in their store. The most important action item, and honestly, it all starts here. In fact, if you don't identify and focus on the top 20% of products that you want to market for the holidays, it makes your marketing impossible. It makes your ability to optimize your listings impossible. It makes your ability to figure out where to keep an eye on your product pricing impossible. Because if you're trying to market every single SKU and keep an eye on every single SKU in your store, there's not any way that there's enough time to do that. So don't market the whole store. What you're going to do is you're going to make a list specifically of the products that you want to focus on selling between now and the end of the year. This is going to involve taking stock of your inventory, making a list in a spreadsheet of what products that you want to market. So what is your holiday inventory? And when I say 20%, people will sometimes say, well, I've got like 25%, or, you know, I've adjusted my inventory balance where really 40% of my inventory is sourced for the holiday season. That's absolutely okay. If you have changed your product mix so that 40% is holiday inventory and 40% is just kind of your general inventory, it may be spring and summer inventory, it may be kind of generic inventory, that's okay. But you want to focus on the products that you really want to get sold between now and the end of the year. So when you are thinking about your holiday inventory, anything that you think is going to have a renewed purpose for the holidays, anything that's already selling well, and anything that you've sourced specifically for the holidays, that goes into that holiday inventory category. Once you have identified, you know, what is the subset of products that I really want to focus on selling over the next 4 months, you're going to know which products to market, you're going to know which products to reprice, you're going to know which products to replenish, you're going to know which products to offer free shipping on. As you can see, when you identify your holiday inventory, make your list, get a spreadsheet, and so that you really have a dashboard of what you're focusing on during the holiday season.